Hi, welcome back to my channel and happy Friday. I have a quick life channel update. I may not upload a video next week. My mom took a slight turn for the worse and we just don't know what's going to happen now. I just wanted to put that out there in case I don't upload a video next week. In front of you, I have my A5 cousin, my A5 hun. This is my A6 Techo, which I use as my diary. This is Bruce's planner. I have his A6 weekly supplement in here. And you can see his shadow walking back and forth. I have the front door open and it's getting really cloudy outside. So I'm gonna try to film before I lose the morning light. So let me show you this one first. And this is sort of a real-time look of my planners. I wasn't able to get caught up in my cousin as well as I had hoped. And then one of the planners that I'm missing in this lineup is my A5 five-year diary. I've been using that as my sketchbook and I haven't sketched in it now in about, I think, 3 weeks. So hopefully this weekend I will try to make the time, if things allow, to get caught up in it so that I can show you, because I was having fun sketching in there. This is the monthly layout. I use this as my gratitude. So every night before I go to bed, after I finish filling in, you know, my daily diary entries, I try to think of one good day, one good thing that happened that day. And it doesn't matter what it is. I tried to do this last year and then I fell off the wagon because I just wasn't seeing like the goodness in everyday life events. I just wasn't seeing it. Well, this year I am trying to make that as my goal. So for example, I found gopher holes December 8th. So I drew a little gopher right there. This is January. Here's February. So that's a look at that. This is my Hobonichi pen. And then I use a yellow gel pen to color in the sun because I do keep track of the weather as well as my journal entries for the day. This is Bruce's A6 weekly supplement. And this has been really, really helpful. And if you have a pet, I highly recommend using the A6 weekly supplement to keep track of your pet's events. In my case, I keep track of Bruce's, his poop, his water, and then down here is either his medication, his ointments, or what else am I doing? He's taking a probiotic as well as fish supplements to try to help improve his skin texture. Bruce is our English bulldog, and when we adopted him, he was just recovering from a really bad case of mange, and I don't know if what he's experiencing now is like a side effect, residual issue from that. It's something we've talked about with the vet, and unfortunately, we just haven't been able to figure it out. He's been unwell since about mid-December, and back then it started with an ear infection. So having this really helped because he was on an antibiotic, which we stopped on the 6th. And so when we had our vet visit on the 8th, she was asking us when he received his last antibiotic pill. And so I looked in here and was able to tell her that the 6th at night was when he was done with it. Because then on Wednesday, he didn't get anything. And then we started him back up on Thursday after the vet visit. But this has really, really helped when I needed to talk to the vet or the vet tech about anything that they have questions about. So this is for Bruce. Highly recommend. It's small enough to put into your purse or your bag and easy to carry. This is my traveler's notebook standard size. I've been using this as my health steps weight tracker. So you can see that here. My weight is in pink or blue, and then the steps, no color. This has been perfect. I really love using it because again, it's in here. And so before I get started in the morning, I fill this out. Over here is where I keep track of my meals, my vitamins over here, sleep. And then I started doing arm weights and squats with the weights. I'm doing baby steps to get back into my exercise, but my weight has been relatively, I think it's at a decent range. You know, because with everybody being sick and the uncertainty, I have discovered that I just don't eat, which I don't recommend you to do. It's just, that's I can't make myself eat when I'm worried sick about everybody. But anyway, so I decided to get back into using my arm weights, and I started squats with the weights. And so I've done it 2 days so far. I'm gonna do it again later today for both. And this has been working really great. In here I have stickers that, this is also the traveler's notebook. And I keep stickers in here. Ta-da. And then I use them in here as I need to. So this is my A6 HON. So now you can see it a little bit better. So this is my writer's notebook. I am hoping to self-publish at the end of the year and the beginning of 2025. At the rate that I'm going, it's looking like maybe 2025. In this monthly, oh, I don't know what to call this, kind of like a year at the glance, my intention was to keep track of the word count, but these little lines are small for me, and it was just a pain in the butt to keep coming back here and writing down my word count, so I stopped. Here's December, January, here's February. This is for next month. I messed up right here, so I just put down a little piece of washi to cover it up. It is what it is. Can't, oh well. This is for this week. A little bit of washi, washi, and then a little bit of stickers, washi, washi. The color is highlighter marker. My intention, again, for this particular HON was to not decorate it, but I missed the color. But it hasn't thickened up the weeks. Let me put this here. But it hasn't thickened it up too much. This one I don't want to thicken up on purpose, like I do for this one. But it's been working out really good. This is my daily page. So today is the 16th. This is the dragon charm that I purchased from Daiso last weekend, I think. But this is what the daily page looks like for me, for my writer's notebook. And I generally highlight the different sections to color it up. I just want to show you what it looked like when I didn't do it. This is what it would look like. And then in the back, I have my colored chickens. So this is also from Suzie O'Connell. She has like a free chicken version, which is what I downloaded. I will also link that down below. So I color coded my chickens. So that when you see the black, they are my flex days, which mean I didn't write at all. Didn't do any writing thing. When you see a solid chicken, I wrote more than 250 words. When it is striped, like you see right here, I was having a writing class or a writing event. So I was doing something writing related, but I just didn't physically write. The polka dots is when I wrote, but I had less than 250 words. It's a little time consuming to do this too, because I know I'm behind in coloring in my chickens, but it's kind of nice to look at a glance what I did or didn't do. This has been working really good. I really enjoy using this. Now to my cousin. Because we've been having a bit more earthquakes, I found a earthquake icon online, and then I printed it out on sticker paper and I put it down so I can see how many times we're getting an earthquake in a month that we can feel. So here we are in February. There's another earthquake that we had. So today's the 16th. This one I actually felt. And then this is for next month. Here is this week. Now where you can see, I put down a lot more stickers. I used a lot more stickers here. When I need to fill this out, I have this one beside me so I can look through it, and then I make it prettier here, trying to use up all the stickers that I have. So the information that you find here is the same here, except this is a bit more functional, whereas this is a bit more pretty looking. This is for last week. And then with the daily, the 16th. So you can see I didn't do anything on these pages. I do have some photos in my phone that I might print out, or I just may sit down and just draw something on top of it, or tape down some images that I found for magazines. This is Bruce, and he looked pretty good. So this was taken in the morning. This is a praying mantis. set. On here, which was Saturday the 10th, I plan on drawing a dragon. That's why I put down a little sticky note of what I want to do on that page. This was the 8th, so I covered up Friday. So this is my husband and Bruce when we were at the vet. Then after we took Bruce home, we were celebrating my husband's birthday, so we went out for a lunch, dinner, meal. This is my mom's cymbidium. When I finally see her, hopefully she'll recognize the cymbidium as hers, but it's blooming outside right now. Still blooming. This is a drawing of Big Bear's, their eagle nest. So when we had the Pineapple Express, so this is the weekend, was really cold and it rained steady for 3 days. We got a lot of rain. Big Bear got a lot of snow. And so this is the nest and she's under there keeping warm. She laid 3 eggs. For this, the sentence, the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog, uses every letter in the English language. I just thought that was so interesting. So I drew that. That's supposed to be Bruce. So this is the second day, actually the first day of the rain. So that's me. I've got my Coraline boots back out. Bruce wouldn't come out. He stayed on the porch. I had put the tarp up over his bathroom area, but he still wasn't interested. So this was a very challenging time to make him go to the bathroom. This is my niece with her cat. On this day, on the 2nd, I caught a double rainbow. I don't know if you can see it. So that's why I put the rainbows down to remind myself what I'm looking at. So one was really, really strong, which is this one here. So this one's this one. And then right here is a faded one. And it was really neat because the rainbow seemed to have crashed into like a house, 2 houses down. And then here's Jackie, the female bald eagle, hunkering down. She laid her 3rd egg before the, she laid her 3rd egg right here. So on the 31st, right before the snow that they experienced came. So that's what this is. So this is like the before, and this would be the after. So I don't know if you can see the difference. So intense with the snow up there that this particular branch was so heavy with snow that it bent down. So you actually got a view of this part of Big Bear that we rarely see because of this huge branch. But if you were to go to the YouTube channel now and look, it looks kind of like this. The snow has melted and now you can see the nest and this branch has come back up. Let's see, where did I draw it? It's kind of like right there. And these eggs, if they're fertile, should hatch on February 29th. That's when the pip watch will start. And pip is meaning when the chick is going to try to break through the egg. So it should be exciting times. So this is a quick real-time look of my planners and how I use them for the past couple of weeks. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you'd like to see after the pin videos of my planners. And I hope to see you guys next week. And if I don't, you'll know why. Have a nice weekend. Bye.